A little cinema verite. We're going to go down to the bridge. We're closing in. The apple tree got tipped over. There's Chris Williams.
Mm-hmm. He was trailing two cars. John Walker.
Yeah.
I wish I'd known it. He died in the fall. I'd have gone down and wrenched him out of there.
Wow. Chris Williams says he's never seen it like this. So it's just about noon. This is the brook by Spring Hill Road next to Zargo's. Lying down. Under Spring Hill. Down into Baker Brook. You listen, you can hear the low frequency noise of boulders flying down under the water. It's sort of quiet up here, a bit of rain. You wouldn't know about the flash flooding until you got there. We're down at the Green Bridge at the end of Parrish Hill, and you can see the water's already gone down.
Let's see if they stop us. Look how high this is.
I know. Wow. So we're later in the afternoon and Baker Brook is going down, but it's still roaring. We're just on the other side of the covered bridge and the water's been going down, but this debris we see is obviously from houses and we smell propane. Somebody's tank is open. Boy, the banks of Baker Brook are clean today, day after the hurricane. The Rock River the morning after. Hey.
Would come to swim in my spot before this.
Just cleaning up.
Yeah. The whole, our swimming hole is gone. 200 years of dust slowly rising from it.
Man.
But it's completely different back there.
So we're down where the Rock River joins the West River. Late morning, the day after. All kinds of wrack and sand gathered many feet above water level. There's the West River. And here's the bridge. still happening. We're back behind the course of the Rock River. This is how it redirected itself yesterday. And here the shed got hung up on the apple tree. The river's changed its course. And out here, it smells like a logging camp. The smell of pine, the scent of sap, cut trees. Extraordinary. This, to me, is Hurricane Irene. New front lawn. Something like a beaver dam. That's the top story of the house. My rough estimate, this tree is 24 inches in diameter. I guess none of this made it to the Williamsville Dam, because it all got caught here.